the shortfall in divestment proceeds will be made up, highlights that there will be no cuts in expenditure and that the government will meet its fiscal deficit target for FY16.
Fiscal deficit target, you've maintained that we will be able to get to that 3.9%. I'm asking you this question in the context because there are now more and more concerns that on the disinvestment front you are going to see a significant shortfall. In that context, should we be concerned at all as far as the macroeconomic fundamentals are concerned?
No, I don't think so. I don't think there is any concern as far as fiscal deficit is concerned. You see, last year I had mentioned that we had a very daunting task in maintaining the fiscal deficit. And it had become a convention in India to cut down on expenditure in order to, because if you can't earn, then you spend less. And that's how we were maintaining the fiscal deficit. And cutting down on expenditure, which had become an Indian model over the last few years, was actually adversely impacting on growth. Therefore, we didn't intend to do so. I had therefore consciously this year kept a very modest fiscal deficit target. That is a movement from 4.1, it eventually became 4%, to 3.9%. And I think the manner in which tax revenues and expenditure are moving, I don't see there is going to be any difficulty. You are right, as far as disinvestment is concerned, there are a few challenges, and the challenges are particularly because on account of the global prices, the metal stocks are not doing particularly well, and metal was a large part of the kitty that we had planned for this year. And therefore, I don't think it makes sense divesting at a time when the prices are low. And I don't think this year we'll have to cut down expenditure of either state governments or public expenditure or the central ministries. As it is, we are moving ahead of our targets as far as indirect taxations are concerned.
Do you think that will be able to meet the shortfall, sir? Which is likely to be more than 30,000 crores on disinvestment?
We are still in the media. And therefore, we've just spent a little more than 6.5 months. We have 5.5 months more to go. The third and the fourth quarter always see a much better growth and a much better collection. And if already on the first 6 months, we are ahead of target as far as indirect revenues are concerned. And I must point out, you see, there are always conflicting views on how much the range in which we will grow. Now, these are all estimates. The real test is of how the economy is doing. Is how much revenue from indirect taxation are you going to collect? And therefore, if your excise collections are moving up, that means manufacturing is moving up. If your customs are moving up, raw materials and capital goods are coming into the country. If your service tax is moving up, partly because of additional revenue measures, and there we seem to be on a reasonably sound footing.
All right, then, time to slip into a short break. But coming up next, State Bank of Mysore posted a good set of earnings. Sharad Sharma, the managing director of the company, will join us on the other side with all the details. Stay tuned.